Welcome to the 11th class. The first chapter in 11th class is sets. We will see what sets are. Now, sets are how we define and what are the necessity of sets, why we study sets. Sets are actually the way we categorize group out of a group. If we think about a collection of objects, let us suppose very diversified objects are there, we can collect similar kind of objects at one place, then those will be considered as sets. I think it will be quite clear if we formally define it. Sets are defined as collection of well-defined group of objects. Collection of well-defined group of objects. So, sets are defined as collection of well-defined group of objects. Now, what does this mean? Collection, we are all aware. Well-defined has some significance there. Well-defined means it should have a fixed definition there. That means there should not be any ambiguity when we define that group. If we are talking about bright students of your class, then the list of bright students will differ in case of each students. Any two of the lists can be same, but not all will be same. That means there is some ambiguity in the definition, and it will not be considered as well defined. Let us take another example. If we need to make a group of all dangerous animals. Now, for some people, dogs are also dangerous, but for others, dogs are only pet animals. They are very loving for some. So the group of dangerous animals will differ in person to person cases. So we will not consider it well defined. That means if any adjective is involved or some personal choice is involved there, then we won't get any well defined definition. That means a fixed definition, well defined things will be not there. It will always be differing. So we have sets, collection of well defined group of objects. Objects, we need not to worry, mathematically we consider all things as objects. Even animals are animals, human beings, all are considered, trees, etc., are considered as object and nothing more than that. Now we will see the representation of sets. How will we representation of sets? There are basically two types of representation. First is roster form. Now roster method, in roster method what we do, we list all the elements. It is known as roster method. And second method is set builder method. For set builder method what we do, we write the definition of the elements. That means we write a definition which is satisfied by all the elements of that group, and we say it set builder. And in roster form we need to represent all the elements there. Now we will see it by an example. Let us suppose we have A is equal to X, such that x belongs to. This is symbol for belongs to. We will discuss it in detail. X belongs to n. Now n is the representation of set of natural numbers. We will also discuss it. X belongs to n, and 1 less than equal to, this is symbol, less than equal to 7. That means x has value lying in between 1 and 7. Now it is the set builder form. It is set builder form. Now when we write it in roster form, we will write it like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. That's it. It will be roster form in which we have written all the elements there. But sometimes it may happen that we won't be able to write all the elements due to the space constraint. We have always a space constraint while we write the solution. Like if we consider a set B and it is defined as Y, such that Y belongs to natural number and Y is greater than 10. Now we have to write all those natural numbers which are greater than 10. So in roster form we will write it 11, because we need to write a natural number more than 10. So it will start with 11, 12, 13, 14. Now what? It will go on. So up to what we need to write the numbers? We need to write 3 or 4 elements so that their pattern becomes clear, that whether there is a gap of 1, 2, 3 or any like, and then we will put dot dot dot. This will signify that the list will go on. Now we will see what belongs to means. Belongs to is this one, represented by this one. This is belongs to. Belongs to. And then if we put a cross over there, we write here does not belong to. Does not belong to. Now let us take an example. Set C, we have 2, 5, 8, 11, 14. Now this is the set which is having 2, 5, 8, 11 and 14 as their elements. Now if the question is, does 1 belongs to C? The answer will be no, because we can see 1 is not belonging to the set C. Does 8 belongs to C? We will write yes. That means 2 belongs to C, 5 belongs to C, 8 belongs to C, 11 belongs to C and 14 belongs to C. But if we are asked 3, 3 does not belong to C, and there are so many, we can write the that is not belonging to the C. So there are actually 5 elements there, so only 5 will be belonging to C. Those are 2, 5, 8 and 14, 11 and 14, and any other number will not be belonging to that, and it is represented by does not belong to. Belong to sign, and then we put a cross sign there, we cancel it like, and this is belongs to. So now it is clear that what belongs to means and what does not belongs to. Now one thing is that in the case of set builder form, let us suppose we are writing a set D X such that. Now this such that can be written like this one as well. That means we can write it like X such that. X such that. Now here definition can be anything, like X is equal to n square. X is equal to n square. n belongs to the set of natural numbers. It will be like this one. Now we can write it like x square, such that now we are acquainted that we can write either colon or this bar for such that x square. We can write the other definition like this one, but these two will represent the same thing. X such that x is equal to n square, n belongs to the set of natural numbers. Now we are defining x square such that x belongs to n. Both will have same elements when we will try to write them in roster form. Like if for the first definition, if we are trying to write the elements, we will begin like this one. We will start from first natural number, that is 1, and we will square it. We will write it 1, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, and so on. And for the second definition also, we will have the same. You can see it is x square, x belonging to n. That means we will do the same thing here, only the way of writing has changed. So the set we represent in set builder form may be different from but their meaning when we write in roster form will be same. That means roster form will not be different. While we define the things to indicate the same, can be different. So I mean to say that definitions may be different, but what are the elements represented or indicated by those definitions must be exactly the same, then only the definition will be correct. That means set builder form will be different for different people, different students, or we can use different formats to define the set, but the roster form will always be same. Let us discuss a question. Write the solution set of the equation in roster form. Now we need to write solution set of the equation x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. So first of all we will solve it. It is x square minus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. We will solve it by splitting the middle term. It will be minus 2x minus 3x plus 6 is equal to 0. Then we will have x minus 2 minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. X minus 2 into x minus 3 is equal to 0. X is equal to 2 or 3. That means we will write in roster form the set A is equal to 2 comma 3, and we will write which is the required set. Let us look at another question. Write the set A 1, 8, 27, 64 and so on in set builder form. That means we need to write here the definition which will represent all the terms of the set A. Now in set builder form we can proceed it like x such that x belongs to n and x is equal to y cube, y is belonging to n. Now how it goes? It goes like we need to take y as natural number, we will cube it and give the outcome, the value to x, and it will be there in the set. So it will be 1 cube, which is equal to 1. Now x will have 1, so 1 will be the first element. Then we will take another 2, another natural number, second natural number, it is 2. 2 cube is 8, and again 3 cube is 27. So each element of given set is represented by this definition. So this is the set builder form for the given set. Now if we look for another definition, we can go like n cube, such that n belongs to n. This is compact and nice definition, and it will represent all the elements there, 1, 8, 27, 64, everything there. Each element will be represented like n cube, such that n is equal to n. Now we can we will begin with 1, the first natural number. 1 cube, it will be 1, 2 cube, it will be 2. So it is quite compact and very nice definition. So we have seen here and in the past as well that the definition of a set may differ, but the roster form will be same.